Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. Now we're going to do a little bit of a little bit of an Humpty Dumpty. One of my favourite breweries, Humpty Dumpty. Everything that I've tasted of theirs has been just absolutely spot on. Really has been absolutely beautiful. Now, let's just move that one up. Oh, blimey. I've still got my plate down here from having dinner. Right, no, it's terrible. Having dinner at the computer. That is the Humpty Dumpty brewery there. There's little Humpty there. Got his name, the brewery, from a big, I don't know if you've seen the Humpty Dumpty beer one, but a big, great big kind of tank on a narrow gauge track, a narrow gauge wheelbase and that, you know. And so you've got this big old tank on over the top of this little wobbly wheelbase, you know. And it's wobbling round on the corners and it's just got its name Humpty Dumpty. The brewery named itself after that, and consequently all the kind of all the brewery, well, I think apart from the Double W IPA, that's the Wherryman's Way IPA. I don't know if that's got anything to do with the trains, but all the other beers there. Think apart from maybe Christmas Crack as well, are named after kind of trains, train stuff and everything else. Right, so I've got this one, nice, kind of nice temperature. It was cold ages ago. It's had a chance to sit and kind of settle and everything else. I've been selling it down in the fridge and everything else. So read them. Right, that's the bottom bit, turn it round a bit, there's the thing, right there, and turn it round a bit more and there's the, all the stuff there, dippy 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 dip. You got it? There you go. Drinkaware.co.uk. You know what I think about all that. I don't know whether it's law that you have to have that on there, but I always think, if you're one of these people that are going to drink while you're pregnant, or you're going to smoke while you're pregnant, or you're going to do anything stupid, or you're going to drink yourself into oblivion, reading that sort of stuff on things, or yeah, the UK chief medical officers recommend all that sort of stuff. If you're sensible, you're going to drink sensible. If you're not sensible, none of that's going to change your mind. It's not going to go, I must look at that website and see how much. It's just me having a... Sorry, it's just me having a rant. Take no notice. But you know what I mean, you know. You ain't going to suddenly read these things. It's like the tax on the beers that they've put. You know, raise the tax on beers and people will stop binge drinking. Well, you know, I can't see the tramp standing on the special brew and everything else and Crest Super 10%. I can't see him suddenly going, do you know what? I think I'll have an alcohol-free beer because there's less duty and stuff on it and all that, you know. No. Just put the price up and... is that gone blurry? Just put the price up and, you know, they'll have a Lambrini instead or whatever, you know. And if failing that, aftershave, antifreeze, mouthwash, they all got high alcohol content. You can get mashed on mouthwash. But there you go, I didn't say that. There is lovely, lovely little green bottle crown. Quite pretty. I like that. And into the Humpty Dumpty glass. And this is Hop Harvest Gold. 4.8 ABV. Right, I ain't gonna pour it. And I've been actually told off for kind of not doing my usual rambling rant or usual rambling chat when I do pour. No, I don't pour it on camera, but I do have a little chat on the way through. God, that's, whoo. And as you pour, you do get lovely, like, little, lovely little smells and things like that. I don't think there's a lot to be described in a pour and that, you know. You pour it how you like. If you pour ahead, you pour ahead. If you don't, you don't. I don't pour ahead. There's not a lot. Just listen, there's not a lot of sedative, not a lot of sediment in there. So I'm kind of pouring the tiny bit there is, just pouring it in. And just showing you that it's ever so slightly hazed to it. But that kind of shows the little Humpty Dumpty on the front there better. With a bit of paper behind it. Where's me paper? Yeah, that'll do. With a little bit of paper behind it, kind of I can show you. If I can get, there we go, the angle there. Yeah, there's that. That's nice, just the colour again. But the smells, have a look at the carbonation running through here as well, look. You can see, look how nice and slow. See, it's bullshit about, sorry. It's, not bullshit, but it's kind of, it's kind of a miscomprehension maybe of bubbles, to kind of say that small bubbles in a beer makes it, you know, makes for a better beer, because I've had small bubbles in things like Coors Light and everything else. But one thing that the bubbles can tell you, if they're raising through the glass fairly slowly like that, you know that the viscosity of the fluid in there, of the liquid, is going to be a little bit richer, a little bit thicker. And so the one thing that those bubbles can tell you, as well as telling you about the carbonation and the gassiness of it, what they can tell you is they can tell you about the mouthfeel you're going to get. So they give you a little bit of a clue to that, which is nice, you know. So there, it looks like it's going to have a lovely mouthfeel. Let's have a sniff. I haven't got any swirling room. Filled it right up. Oh, wowza. You're getting kind of a distant mintiness, almost a distant pine. But you're also getting lovely, lush grapefruit, sanguinella orange. You're getting the kind of and a little fistless. I always do that if I could fistless. Try them fistless. They are lovely. You got to try them. You really have got to try them. Little silly little orangey things. Very expensive, but oh, they nice. Right, let's dive in. Cheers. As usual, you can just trust these guys. Oh wow, the taste going on there. There's the one to go and buy and try, because I'm telling you that already. Definitely go and buy it and try it. The flavours going on in here are unbelievable. It goes down two roads, it seems. And you've got the hoppy, lovely, kind of fruity stuff going on in there. And then you've got the malty sort of bread in there. And they kind of come together in a beautiful concerto of harmonious flavours in there that just kind of, it's, you know, it's kind of a, if you ever had, like, you get grapefruit marmalades and things like that, get grapefruit marmalade on lightly toasted buttered toast, and then have, and tell me if it's like a bit similar. Oh, that's lovely. There's a distant peppering in there as well. But, oh, there's a flavour I can't put my finger on. I don't know what it is. But it's a beautiful, lovely, lovely flavour. Wow, that is so gorgeous. Mmm. Listen, don't take my word for it. I don't know whether you can get this on Ales by Mel or Beers of Europe. You may be able to get it directly from the boys at the brewery itself. I don't know. You certainly can if you kind of visit Reedham and that. If you visit the brewery, it's Reedham, isn't it? Yeah. On the picturesque Norfolk Broads and that. Really beautiful. That's Umpty Dumpty. Go to the brewery. Go and have a mixture of all their stuff. They are amazing. They really are. Nice bunch of guys as well. They're not kind of big-headed. They're not like, yeah, we're the best brewery. Yeah, crap and all that. No, they're not big-headed, but they are absolutely fantastic. Well, cheers, guys. That is beautiful. As I said so many times already, go out, buy it and try it. It's beautiful. Chin chin, bottoms up, touch glasses. Bye.